glad you came over, Throckmorton. It's been a lovely evening.
Yeah, I enjoy turning the lights down and watching television. How about tomorrow night, Lois?
Oh, I'm sorry. You didn't ask me soon enough.
Oh, Wilbur again?
Maybe. Oh, don't forget your hat.
Oh. Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, good night, Lois.
Good night, Throckmorton.
Good night.
Night.
Is this Wilbur's?
Well, he might have left it here.
Lois, I want to talk to you about that pinhead. Now, sit down. Look here. Is he the one you have a date with tomorrow night?
Now, just a minute. I don't ask you who you go out with.
Well, I don't go out with anybody. Much.
Oh, no. Lately, I've just gotten to be Wednesday night Lois.
Well, I just asked you for tomorrow night.
What happened? Your Thursday night girl turn you down?
Lois.
Oh, Throckmorton. You know, you're just about as fickle as you can be.
Me? Look who's calling who. Fickle.
Well, after all, I can't sit around waiting for you to call. At least I can depend on Wilbur.
Lois, give him up. Break your date with him tomorrow night. Think how much fun we can have here tomorrow night. I hate to think of anyone sharing our moon with you.
Oh, I wish I could believe that.
You can. You know you're the only girl for me, Lois.
Throckmorton, you've said that before.
Oh, I can prove it. I won't go out with any other girl but you. Not that I do anyway. How about those? Tomorrow night?
Well.
Come on, Lois.
Well,
how about it?
Till tomorrow night.
Not yet, Bertie. Leroy's still out front waiting for him.
Okay. When the mail comes, tell him I'll be in the kitchen.
Hello, my dear.
What are you doing with the pictures, Unky?
Yeah, I'm taking them out in the garage.
All of them?
No. I left Lois's up in my room. Since last night, I'm a one-woman man.
Mail call! Nothing for you but a bill, Unc.
Yeah, that's normal.
Nobody got a letter except Bertie.
Did Bertie hear mail call?
Yeah. Here, Bertie.
Thanks.
Gee, she's happy.
Yeah, she certainly is.
Bertie got a letter yesterday and acted the same way.
Heck, she gets a letter almost every day now.
Unky, wouldn't it be wonderful if this is the real thing for Bertie?
Yes, indeed. Bertie'd make a wonderful wife for some deserving man.
Bertie married? Gosh, if she leaves, the house will come unglued.
Oh, you're not thinking of the house. You're thinking of your stomach.
Yeah.
Well, I'm afraid we're all a little spoiled. Bertie's been with us so long.
Bertie wouldn't run out on me after all these years.
Come right here.
Well, what do you think, Uncle?
It looks like we're going to have a wedding around here.
Looks like we're coming unglued.
Bertie. You seem very happy lately.
Yes, Mr. Gildersleeve. Will you excuse me, please, while I get this roast ready for the oven?
We've been wondering if these letters you've been receiving have anything to do with it. That song sounded like a wedding. Bertie, are you planning to get married? Bertie!
Oh, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Well, anyone as giddy as you are is bound to be getting married. Have you set the day yet?
No, sir. But we're going to set the day any night now, and that'll be the day.
Well, congratulations from all of us.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Yeah, I don't know if you've made any plans for setting up housekeeping, but we'd be delighted to have you stay here with us.
Oh, Mr. Gildersleeve, I've enjoyed it here. But my to-be and me have ideas of a vine-covered cottage.
Well, good for you.
But I'm not going to leave you until you get somebody in my place.
Oh, well, thank you, Bertie. I'll put an ad in the paper in the morning.
Yes, sir. Now, don't you worry. I'm not going to leave you in the lurch because I'm heading for the church.
Yeah, I know, Bertie.
I'm not going to leave you in the lurch because I'm heading for the church.
Yeah, well.
Mr. Gildersleeve, you know what I'm not going to do. I'm
yes,
not going to leave you in the lurch because I'm heading for the church.
Yeah. should be receiving some callers today.
Yes, sir.
Bertie, you know what we need in a housekeeper. Do you mind screening them for me?
Oh, Bertie will sift them all right. They've got to come up to snuff.
Yes, indeed. We're spoiled.
We got to get somebody who can sew and mend.
You bet.
When we get somebody who can put a fire in their cooking. None of this anemic stuff. She'll be feeding a growing boy.
You bet. And a growing man.
Mrs. Hogan, and thank you for coming by. Mr. Gildersleeve can't put in a dishwasher, do the marketing, and put a television in the kitchen, too.
Tightwad.
Bonjour.
Good morning. Come right in.
I am Yvonne de Baillet.
How do you do?
I hope I'm not too late.
Late?
Down, Unc.
Well, I saw your ad in the paper for a housekeeper and came to inquire.
Oh? You're so young. Have you had much experience?
I have in Paris. How many are there in the family here?
Well, there's Mr. Gildersleeve, his niece, and his nephew.
No wife?
He's a bachelor.
Oh.
How are we doing, Bertie?
How do you do, monsieur?
How do you do? Yeah, I'll take over now, Bertie.
Yes, sir.
Did you say your name was?
Yvonne de Baillet. Yeah.
Won't you sit down, Miss de Baillet?
Merci.
Yo, this is my nephew, Leroy, Miss de Baillet.
How do you do?
Merci.
Leroy, wouldn't you like to run out and play?
No, I want to stay and listen.
Leroy. Now, tell me something about yourself, Miss de Baillet.
I'm a very good cook, if you like the French cuisine.
Oh, love it.
Would you like to see my credentials, monsieur?
No, thank you. I've seen enough. What I mean is, I'm a quick judge of character.
Then I will do.
Well.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Bertie. Probably another applicant. Tell him we're not interviewing anyone else.
Yes.
Have you been in Summerfield very long?
No, monsieur.
Why, Miss Kimball, come in.
Hello, Bertie.
Do you mind staying home? Mm-hmm.
No, monsieur.
Do you have any ties that would prevent... Gosh, I didn't expect you.
I'm sure you didn't. I had no idea you were, entertaining.
No, I'm not. Yeah, I'm not.
Here's your hat. He has a habit of leaving at places, in case you don't know.
Lois, I'm interviewing new mates. Miss Kimball? Miss de Baillet?
Mademoiselle.
How do you do?
What do you think?
Keep looking.
No. No, I'm sorry, Miss de Baillet, but I think perhaps I'd just better stick to plain home cooking.
I understand. If you should change your mind.
He won't.
No, I'm afraid not. Well, thank you very much for coming.
Tell Mr. Gildersleeve that he can turn everything over to me. I'm used to running things.
I'm sure you are.
Land sakes! Excuse me!
Children!
Well, I didn't know there were children.
That does it. Mr. Gildersleeve!
Hey, what is it, Bertie?
Mr. Gildersleeve, I want to talk to you. It's important.
Important? Well, what is it?
Mr. Gildersleeve, I'm not going to get married.
What's this?
I'm not going to leave you, Marjorie and Leroy, in the hands of such as showed up here today.
But, Bert...
You've been too good to me.
Now, we'll find
that
someone.
That last one didn't even like children.
She didn't.
I'm not turning this family over to just anybody. No, sir, I'm not turning this family over to just anybody.
Unky? We can't let Bertie stay when she's dying to get married.
Well, staying was her idea. as much a surprise to me as it is to you.
Well, let's face it, we're standing in the way of her happiness.
Yeah, I know, and I wouldn't do that for the world.
Have you noticed how quiet she is this evening?
She's miserable, torn between us and wanting to get married. We've got to get her to go.
Well, I know, but how?
Well, I don't know. Unless you fired her.
Oh, you know I couldn't do that.
Hey, tell her you lost your job with the water department and can't pay her.
Oh, she'd stay for nothing for us.
I've got it. Tell her we're selling the house.
Well, she'd stay until we did. And then where would we live?
Unky?
Yes, my dear?
Bertie always said you'd be better off married.
Married? Oh, no. I'm willing to make a lot of sacrifices for Bertie's happiness, but not marriage.
Nobody knows my sorrow.
Oh, I can't stand this. I'm going to have to tell Bertie that I'm getting married.
Mr. Gildersleeve?
Now, you two play along.
Okay. Yes, sir?
Yeah, Bertie, come and sit down. Gather around, children. I have an announcement I want the whole little family to hear.
Yes, sir?
Now, it may come as a great surprise to you that Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve, water commissioner and lifelong bachelor, has decided to take a wife.
Married? How about that?
Oh, I'm so happy for you.
Good. Then you go right ahead with your plans, Bertie.
I never thought you'd do it. Who's the lucky lady?
Hey, lucky. Well,
I bet I know. Miss Lord Kimball?
Now, let's not speculate, Bertie.
No, sir, but that's who it is, isn't it?
Well, nothing's for publication.
Mr. Gildersleeve, you're not spoofing about getting married, are you?
No, I'm on the level.
Oh, yes.
Oh, Bertie's mighty glad. Now, this makes everything super-duper. Bertie can now say, I do.
That's right. Right, Benjamin. Tell him to set the day.
Now, I want to do something for you, Mr. Gildersleeve.
Oh?
Bertie wants to serve you and your bride to be a big engagement dinner.
Engagement dinner?
How about tomorrow night?
Well, that's fairly short notice, Bertie.
Oh, yes, sir. I got to get going tomorrow night.
Well.
Yes, sir. Now we're going to celebrate. A wife is what this house has always needed.
Well, no need making a big thing out of it, Bertie.
Oh, yes, indeed. We'll celebrate. Because every good man needs a good wife. That's what I've always told Benjamin. Da, da, da. Da, da, da. Da, da,
can I be flower boy?
Roy, I'm just pretending to take a wife, remember?
You still need a reasonable facsimile tomorrow night.
Yeah, I know.
What about Lois Kimball? Isn't she your one and only?
She sure is. That's why I couldn't pretend with Lois.
Unc, want me to get your other girls out of the garage?
No, I don't want to have an engagement dinner with anyone I know. They might sue me for breach of promise.
Why don't you advertise for somebody? A let's pretend wife.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, and besides, it's too late to get it in the paper now.
Okay, advertise over television. Go phone the station right now.
Yeah? And let everybody in town know about it?
Well, there's an idea there, Unky.
What?
Why don't you phone the station and get a TV actress?
An actress? Yeah. I know the manager down there. He might dig up one for me.
Why dig one up? Get a live one.
Hello, Mr. Peavy.
Well, hello there, Bertie. What can I do for you today?
Mr. Peavy, will you send a quart of Mr. Gildersleeve's favorite ice cream over the house tonight about 7 o'clock?
Very well. One quart of Tutti Frutti.
We're having a big engagement dinner over at our house tonight.
You don't say. Margie?
No, sir. Did Mr. Gildersleeve tell you?
No, I haven't seen him today.
He's getting married.
Married? Well, then I guess that's why I haven't seen him.
He just told the family last night.
Ah, he's marrying Miss Kimball, I take it.
Couldn't be nobody else. Just the other day, he took all his other girls and put them out in the garage. Don't forget the ice cream.
My.
Leroy, what are you doing?
We need some decorations to convince Bertie you're really getting married.
Well, let's not overdo it. Bertie home yet?
No, she's still shopping.
Good.
There.
Yes, we'll use this in the fashion show next week, Mimi. Gimbal Creations.
Hello, Lois. This is Throckmorton.
Oh, hello, Throckmorton. I'm so glad you called. I'm afraid I owe you an apology.
Oh?
I guess I was sort of a meanie about that French girl you were interviewing yesterday.
Oh, that.
For a moment, I thought you'd gone back to your old fickle ways.
Oh, no. Lois.
Yes?
I'm afraid I'll have to cancel our little date tonight.
Oh, no. Do you have to work at the office?
Well, no, not exactly. But some things have developed which demand my attention. Yeah, I'll explain later.
You don't have to explain. We don't have a date, we don't have a date.
But of course you know you're still my one and only.
I'm so glad. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Now, remember, Miss Francis.
Oh, don't you think you'd better call me Mona if we're supposed to be engaged?
Oh, yes. Now, you must convince Bertie that you can take over the house, do the cooking, and make a home for the little family.
Don't you worry. Mother roles come natural to me. Of course, I've never played one away from the TV camera.
Bertie's a tougher audience, believe me. Marjorie. Leroy, what's the meaning of all this?
You're engaged.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Miss Francis, I'd like to have you know my niece, Marjorie.
How do you do?
Hello.
And my nephew, Leroy.
Hello, Leroy.
Hi.
What a nice family.
Now, everybody on his toes. Oh, Bertie!
Yes, sir?
I have someone here I want you to meet.
Yes, sir?
May I take your wrap, Miss Frank? Mona.
Thank you, darling.
Hey, Bertie, this is my fiancée.
It is?
Miss Mona Francis.
Hello, Bertie. How do you do, Miss Francis? Mr. Gildersleeve sure has kept you a secret.
Well, we haven't known each other very long. It was love at first sight. Sort of.
It was for me, darling. I hope you two will be very happy.
Thank you, Bertie.
I wish you lots of happiness, too, Unc.
All of us do, Unky.
Well, thank you.
Well, if you'll excuse Bertie, she'll get back to her kitchen. Bertie's pretty particular about what goes on the table around here.
I'm the same way, Bertie. I just love to spend most of my day in the kitchen.
Yes, ma'am.
Bertie?
Yes?
Do I smell something burning?
Not in my kitchen.
Hello, Miss Peavy.
Hello, Miss Kimball. Miss Kimball. Well, I'm surprised to see you here this evening.
Why should you be surprised?
Well, I just thought you'd be somewhere else this evening.
Now, what makes you think I'd be somewhere else?
Yeah, well, aren't you going to be? Or have you been already?
Mr. Peavy, what are you trying to say?
Yeah, I probably shouldn't try to say anything.
Well, now, just a minute, Mr. Peavy. What's this all about?
Well, perhaps I've got the wrong impression about what's going on.
What is going on?
Well, I'm afraid you'll have to take that up with Mr. Gildersleeve. I'm sorry, Miss Kimball.
Oh, you thought that I'd be with him tonight?
Well, I didn't think you'd be here with the party ice cream going over there.
Party ice cream?
Well, what I mean to say is...
Never mind, Mr. Peavy.
Miss Kimball, don't you want the magazine to read?
I'm going to read the riot act.
Now, wait a minute, Miss Kimball. My, my. I hate myself.
Do you think I'm convincing as the future Mrs. Gildersleeve?
Yeah, you're doing fine. You certainly opened Bertie's eyes the way you've taken command at the table.
I'll say, I always got a second piece of pie.
Throckmorton, when we're married, I think I'll change the wallpaper in this room.
Gosh, Bertie picked this paper.
Oh, it really isn't bad, Bertie.
No, ma'am. More coffee, anybody?
Thank you, Bertie. It was a wonderful dinner. Wonderful.
Thank you, sir.
Well, as long as I don't drink coffee, how about another piece of pie?
Leroy, you'll have to ask Miss Frances.
Leroy, I'm afraid I'll have to be a little strict and see that you get a balanced diet.
He get a balanced diet?
Well, you can see Miss Frances is going to take good care of this bird.
Yes.
Although I don't blame Leroy, it was excellent pie.
Wait till you taste mine.
Miss Frances, how do you make your pie crust?
How do I make it?
Yeah, well, dinner's over. What do we talk about now?
Pie.
Bertie's always interested in improving her cooking. Now, just how did you say you made your pie crust?
Well, I take some pie and a pan. You have to have a pie pan, you know. And, well, I've done it so often that I just don't pay any attention to what I put in it.
Yes, ma'am.
Like a lot of good cooks, I never measure anything.
I see.
Somebody's at the back door.
That could be Benjamin.
Is that the boyfriend, Bertie?
Never mind, Bertie. Leroy will go to the front door. You go ahead.
Hi. Sure. I can't have any more pie anyway.
Well, I guess we can all go in the living room.
Oh, Miss Kimball.
Hello, Leroy.
Oh, brother. Do you suppose Bertie knows I can't cook?
No, I think we're over that hurdle. Nothing else can go wrong now.
Bruce, well, of all things.
Company, darling?
Oh, am I interrupting something?
You know, this is something I was going to explain later on.
Oh, it's a secret.
I'm the future Mrs. Throckmorton P. Gildersleeve.
Well.
She's an actress. She's from television.
She's from what?
I'm not breaking up a romance, am I?
Not at all. You're perfectly welcome to it.
Lois, you don't understand.
No, I don't.
Well, Bertie wants to leave and get married.
Well, it looks like everybody wants to get married.
So you see, I had to come up with a wife.
That's me.
Yeah, she's only temporary. It all makes sense.
A temporary wife makes no sense to me.
It's very simple. He wanted me because he's losing his housekeeper.
Yeah, Bertie wants to leave, you know.
Are you trying to tell me you have to get married to get a housekeeper?
Yes. Yeah, I mean, no. What I mean to say is, I only hired her for one night.
Oh, she's just on trial. How nice.
Lois, listen to me.
I listened to you when you said I was your one and only.
You are. Yeah, I put all my other girls in the garage.
Well, let them out because I'm through.
Lois, you aren't letting me explain.
Oh, Throckmorton, I've heard tall stories and phony explanations before, but this one tops them all. You reservoir Romeo.
That's it. You get out of my kitchen.
What's going on in the kitchen?
Sounds like Bertie's having troubles, too.
Mr. Gildersleeve, I'm sorry I dropped the pans, but I just dropped my boyfriend.
You did?
I just found out he expects me to support him. And if I'm going to work for somebody, I'm going to get paid for it. So I'm staying right here.
Wonderful, Bertie.
Oh, boy.
Oh, Bertie.
Because I see this house needs a good cook. You see?
My job's done. Now, if you'll excuse me, I think I'd better go.
Oh, yes. Well, thank you ever so much.
Bye-bye.
It was awfully kind of you to come and help me out.
Oh, not at all.
And goodbye.
Bye.
Now do you believe me, Lois?
Oh, Throckmorton. It was wrong of me not to trust you.
Like I always say, you're my one and only.
I'll get it, Unc.
Yeah, thank you, my boy.
Hello?
Is this the Gildersleeve residence?
Yes, it is.
Who is it, Lira? Well. Yes?
I came in answer to your ad for a housekeeper.
I'll handle it, Unc.
No, I'll handle it, my boy.
No, I'll handle it, Throckmorton. Excuse me, if you'll just step outside with me, please.
Too bad, Unc.
Yeah.
But I'll bet you couldn't bake as good a pie as Bertie.
That's right, my boy.
Throckmorton.